Massage guns, or percussive therapy devices, claim to increase athletic performance, accelerate recovery, and increase mobility. And if those claims are true, massage guns should make you a faster cyclist. But what does the research say? Are these claims true? And is there any research on the effects of massage guns specifically on endurance athletes? Here at Trainer Road, we dug into the science so you don't have to. While most people assume massage guns are for working out knots in our muscles, science has not been able to corroborate that. Instead, it seems like what massage guns are best at is increasing blood flow to our muscles and joints. When a massage gun makes contact with our skin, the high-frequency vibrations stimulate blood flow in that region, delivering all the many useful things that get carried in our blood, like red and white blood cells, and micronutrients like crucial energy replacement, and the ability to remove byproducts in our muscles that could impede performance and delay recovery. As straightforward as all of that sounds, it's important to not go overboard with massage guns. There's no need to apply significant pressure on the massage gun, and while some brands claim that specific frequencies are uniquely therapeutic, third-party research doesn't back that up. Simply letting the massage gun do its thing while it's making contact with your skin is what researchers recommend. And while we're at it, how often and for how long should you use the massage gun? Research suggests that massage guns are best used in 5-minute doses and in conjunction with your training. But oddly enough, even though we're used to pairing the concept of massage to training as a post-training activity, research shows that massage guns are most useful if used just prior to training. But more on that later. For now, let's get into some good old-fashioned myth-busting with scientific research on massage guns. And first things first, let's not bury the lead here. All of us cyclists care most about improving performance, so what does the research say about massage guns improving performance for endurance athletes? Unfortunately, current research doesn't have a lot in the way of massage gun studies affecting the performance of elite endurance athletes, so this one is really yet to be determined. But just for kicks, we do have a 2019 study by Otadi and colleagues that has some interesting findings that could possibly apply to time to exhaustion, but more likely something else that does indeed improve performance. They took 30 healthy, non-athletic young males and split them into two groups and performed a randomized crossover study with a massage group and a no massage group. And yes, you're probably already thinking of what I thought of when I first saw this study. Coach Jonathan, how did they avoid the placebo effect in this study? Well, to be honest, rather than avoiding it, I just think they fully embraced it. And I think that's really important because the placebo effect has been proven to show performance improvement in a lot of studies. Think about it this way. Since massage guns feel good, is it the worst thing in the world if something that makes you feel good also has the chance to make you perform better?
Oh, I like that.
Me too, Blake. Me too. For both groups in this study, 30 seconds after a max effort, they applied the massage gun to their legs for 5 minutes, with the only difference being that the massage group had the massage gun actually vibrating on their leg, while the non-massage group had the massage gun applied to their leg following the same movement pattern, but it was not vibrating. The results? The massage gun had a, quote, significant positive effect on extending time to exhaustion. But looking closer at the results, what exactly does significant positive effect mean? Well, athletes that were part of the massage group were able to maintain 50% of their maximum voluntary contraction for 8% longer than the control group. Putting this in perspective, it only came out to be 2 seconds difference. But if you think of a sprint scenario, a lot can happen in the space of 2 seconds. They didn't find any internal mechanism that could be tied to this extension in time to exhaustion. So for now, we're simply left to believe that this was at least partially due to the placebo effect. But you know what? I'm not above that. Sign me up for any and all placebos I can get. It's also worth noting that other studies from Taiaz and Conrad and others back up the findings from this one, finding little to no performance improvement that can be tied to anything other than the placebo effect. So let's recap. Do massage guns improve endurance performance? Due to the tricky nature of the placebo effect, I think that you can deem this one plausible at best. But as of now, we lack scientific evidence that shows that anything is actually happening in the muscle from that massage gun that is driving performance improvement. So how about the next claim of accelerating recovery? If massage guns can help us recover better, that should help us adapt to training more rapidly, maybe even tolerate more training load. Is there better research on this? Well, yes, but there's a catch with this one as well. In a 2014 study with Taiaz and colleagues, they looked into whether massage guns could perform better than just traditional manual massage at reducing DOMS, or delayed onset muscle soreness.
My fingers hurt.
They took 45 healthy, female, non-athletic subjects and split them into 3 groups: control, vibration, and massage. Each group performed 30 slow, heavy curls.
4,002.
For the control group, they did nothing before this exercise. For the massage group, they had a standard 15-minute manual massage technique applied to the bicep. And for the vibration group, they did only 5 minutes of massage from a massage gun at 50 hertz with consistent pressure on the bicep. For each subject, they recorded the following: soreness, maximal isometric force, 1 rep max, range of motion, and concentrations of creatine kinase and lactate dehydrogenase, two compounds that are very closely related to muscle damage. What they found is that muscle soreness and creatine kinase were lower for the massage and vibration groups than they were for the control group. And interestingly, they found that lactate dehydrogenase was lowest in the vibration group, a slightly higher in the massage group, and highest in the control group. All of this suggests that using a massage gun will perform similarly, if not even a little better, than traditional massage in helping prevent delayed onset muscle soreness. Which is great news, particularly for all you cyclists that got excited by our recent announcement here at TrainerRoad of supporting running in the TrainerRoad app and decided to go out and try running for yourself. The DOMS is so bad, I can hear it from here. So to recap, do massage guns accelerate recovery? Well, it does seem to reduce DOMS, and while recovery is more complex than just delayed onset muscle soreness, this one does seem to be likely. And that just leaves us with the final claim of increasing range of motion, which we won't dive too deeply into. In a 2020 study from Conrad and a 2022 study from Imtiaz, they both showed that using a massage gun for 5 minutes prior to exercise on the leg muscles actually improved range of motion in lower leg joints. So if avoiding injuries that are related to limited range of motion is a concern of yours, then it seems like a helpful tool to have in your toolbox. But what about risks? I mean, it seems like it's just a massage gun and it couldn't do any harm, but there are actually two published observational studies that are pretty shocking. In 2020, Chen et al. Published an observational study that linked massage gun use to rhabdomyolysis, which is a serious condition that is linked to severe muscle damage. In this observational study, a person received massage gun treatment from a coach after performing a typical session on a spin bike in a gym. 3 days later, they were experiencing severe pain, severe fatigue, multiple hematomas on their thighs, tea-colored urine, and extremely, even undetectably high levels of creatine kinase, which again is a marker for severe muscle damage and parallels with rhabdomyolysis. Researchers noted that the level of cycling exercise performed in that session wasn't unprecedented for them at all, so that isn't likely the culprit in this case. Now, it's still unknown whether this person received massage gun treatment per instructions from a manufacturer, but it seems that misuse is the alleged implication with this study. In another observational study, Sulkowski and colleagues saw a case where after using a massage gun with extreme intensity, duration, and frequency, they experience vertebral artery dissection. Or in other words, a tear in the inner lining of the vertebral artery, which is commonly linked to an increase in likelihood of stroke occurrence. In both of these cases, it seems clear that massage guns were being misused to extreme measures. And it's very important to remember that the effectiveness of massage guns comes from the vibration, not from any pressure added on to the massage gun itself. Additionally, it seems best to use them for short 5 minute periods prior to exercise and avoid excessively frequent use. So, after combing through all the current scientific research on massage guns, what's the verdict? Should you as an endurance athlete be using a massage gun? As long as you're using the massage gun as instructed from the manufacturer, it seems a relatively low risk way to possibly avoid injuries related to range of motion and possibly even reduce delayed onset muscle soreness. But at least for now, according to the scientific research, you shouldn't expect any sort of performance improvement that you wouldn't get from some sort of minor placebo effect, if you believe in that sort of thing. In conclusion, cost has to be considered as well, with some massage guns being as expensive as $500 and the average price of the top 10 recommended massage guns coming out to about $244. That's a decent chunk of change that you'd be spending on something that isn't guaranteed to give you a tangible performance improvement. Compare that to an annual TrainerRoad subscription that ends up costing you less than $16 a month. It has over 16,000 positive reviews in the App Store and an average rating of 4.9 stars. If you're looking for the best way to get faster and you have to choose between the two, it's an easy choice. And on that note, if you haven't already, head over to TrainerRoad.com and sign up. Join the thousands of people around the world that are using AI to get faster with TrainerRoad. Like this video, please share it with your friends, and if you haven't already, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss the next time we dig into the science so you don't have to. See you soon.